Okay. Let me find my camera. It's here somewhere. Hi. There we are. Anjalli, say hi to everybody. And first, show your lovely bottle.
Yeah, this is my steel Zomato bottle, everyone. That's right. Please carry your own water bottle. I carried this. And by the way, they allowed it on the flight.
That's right. And the flight should have been, but isn't, a Volvo XC40 Recharge, which is all about electric. It's an EV. And we're going to discuss that in detail. This is our special Cyrus Drives. What an ego, no? I don't know anybody who has shows that only name the shows after himself. Cyrus walks, Cyrus sleeps, Cyrus drives. By the way, I'll just clear this mess, which is caused by the people doing work in the building at the same time.
Oh,
Anjalli, the show's about you, huh? So you have to keep talking and telling me about yourself. I should have read your bio. I didn't. I should have researched some questions. I forgot. But these are small matters, right? And you come from a long journey of 1 hour, 50 minutes on a plane.
Yeah.
The cities haven't moved. It used to be 1 hour, 15 minutes in 1990. And now suddenly they've made it 1.5 hours.
Yeah.
How do they add 15 minutes? By the way, let's start. All right, this, take a look at this. It's one of the most sophisticated buildings.
Don't go under the ladder, Cyrus. It's bad,
bad luck.
Luck.
I know. But take a look at this. This is beautiful. These guys on the first floor, they don't like using the lift. They just keep two ladders here. And off they go. Now, of course, he's only opened one gate. My gate man. Hey, Darban, gate kho! The real guys come looking very bad. Anjalli, give me a second now, because I have to put windows up also and make an illegal turn.
Yeah.
No, there's nothing illegal in Mumbai. Nobody knows what's legal anymore.
Yeah, go slow.
But we have to start about your life before you run out of time.
Oh, okay.
And you just told me before we started that you actually grew up. I thought you're a Bangalore girl, and well, because you're in Bangalore, I just thought for some reason you're Bangalorean or Delhi or something.
Mm-hmm.
But you're Mumbai. You're a Mumbaiker.
So I grew up in Bangalore. And then I moved to Delhi for college.
I can't get your accent. It's very neutral. I'm not getting like a Mumbai or Bangalore.
It's a pakka South Indian accent.
It is?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
People say, sometimes they say, oh my God, Cyrus, that's Ayush Radha.
Cyrus da. Cyrus da nahi hua.
No, I'm not. I don't do so many da's.
Okay, you're not a da person.
Yeah. Maybe you just call me pan-Indian.
Okay, all right. So you took offense. Okay, fair. As long as I've said the right things, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, let me introduce you properly first. Head Sustainability Officer Zomato, right?
Chief Sustainability Officer, yeah.
One word also I couldn't remember. It's just a medication I'm on.
Hmm.
So, which is now a huge thing. Okay, let's face it. I mean, every company is really worried if they don't get that right. Forget PR. The company itself logically is doomed. And when you're looking at something which is just all human contact, which is Zomato and what you all stand for and everything, I would presume that your role is paramount. And I expect you to have at least 50% equity in the company by now.
Wow. Well, the first statement is true.
Yeah.
The role is really important.
Do you like the fact the wipers are on and there's no rain?
Yeah, Cyrus.
Would you like to call me an idiot?
I want to say what my driving instructor said many years ago.
You know, no, come on, tell us that story. Yeah, tell us that story.
So, when I first moved to Bombay, I decided to learn to drive. And I took lessons from Bhogilal Driving School.
So we are promoting Zomato, Volvo, XC40 and Bhogilal Driving School, all in one show.
And very importantly, my instructor took me for one lesson in pouring rain of Bombay. And we were sort of inching upwards, on this steep incline in Bandra West. And it was raining simultaneously and I couldn't see anything. So I turned the wiper on and he said, wiper band kijiye, battery down ho jayega. And then I was in shock because I didn't know what to do. But I really thought that was
So let's get the point here. Huh. Bhogilal said, Mr. Bhogilal's son or whoever he was, said that you shut the battery, wiper. So you can't see. Visibility is gone now.
Yeah.
It's pouring.
Basically die.
But at the funeral, they can discuss the fact that sustainability. See, you saved the battery. You saved the environment. So you understand this is a very karmic story.
Okay, ultimately, well, I'll tell you what is really the karmic story.
Huh.
How I started in sustainability was I had, you know, straight during my MBA, I was one of those very annoying girls.
Wait, go slow. MBA was where? Because
in FMS Delhi, which was
FMS?
It stands for the Faculty of Management Studies.
Glad you remember that.
So, so I was doing an MBA there, and I was really annoying classmate. I was that really annoying classmate because
you're telling me
I would attend all of these corporate presentations, and I would put up my hand and say, "What is your CSR policy?" And my classmates would just
as go, an MBA student.
Yeah,
so this is way back
2003. So,
and you were ahead of the curve completely.
So all my classmates would want to just sort of bury themselves in the soil. And you won't believe some companies even laughed at the question at that time. Like, no one would laugh at CSR today, right?
My God.
It's like a requirement.
They lose their job, anti-woke.
Exactly. But the point is...
I was about to, but...
it's okay, Cyrus. You have what is called comedic license.
And stupidity. Stupidity is an important thing.
So, but importantly, at that time, it was something that people actually laughed at. And
where did you get the idea from? Anjali, you don't sound like a goody-goody to me. And it sounds more like when you're in MBA school, you're asking these questions. It sounds more like, not to sound insincere, but you know what I mean?
Well, I basically figured that the current system, and I was a student of economics before that, the current system wasn't really working for the majority of the people. Effectively, I mean, you had these sort of islands of prosperity, or you had companies that were doing well, individuals that were doing really well, but the rest of humanity was struggling, frankly. And it still continues.
Communism. What the hell?
No, well, it's an important thing. Well, it's a very obvious, if you don't need to be a communist to recognize that it's...
No, and basically, I wouldn't say corporate India, corporate world. Basically, if you think about that initially, it's almost like a handicap, right? Because you're trying to sell products and get the best bang for your buck, etc., etc. And
true.
This worldview, I would think, is more like something that happens with age later on in life.
Unless you see the opportunity that business can provide. For instance, like what I do now.
You found a matlabi reason for this? my mind is boggling.
No, I think that, look, I think business has a tremendous role to play in terms of creating opportunity, right? Like Zomato creates lakhs of earning opportunities, right? For delivery partners. And every business creates, there is value generated in whatever way. It could be, look at the car we're driving in right now. It's helping us get from point A to
point B. Are you talking about the XC40 Recharge? Volvo?
Yes. Woohoo! Yeah. I think that business has...
Let's get back to the story. Yeah. So you started telling them and they were like looking like eyebrows raised and...
Yeah, so...
Who's this young punk trying to teach us business...
I went ahead and joined a company that sold washing machines.
Who?
I'm not gonna.
Can Google it. They'll Google it. I mean, people are so petty. They will Google it now.
Okay.
Anjalli Ravi Kumar, full name. Now Google it.
So I went and joined Whirlpool.
Whirlpool,
which is a really cool company because it saves women a lot of labor and hard work.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, in the sense, washing machines replace the need for
the
hand
idea
washing.
Of the washing machine. Yeah.
So I mean, I did really admire Whirlpool for what it was doing. However, there was this one situation that I was in where I was trying to sell washing machines in parts of Chennai where there was no water.
Wow.
Like there was a water problem.
This is nothing, not to do with the Kaveri water dispute, please. I don't want people to write in.
No, but it was just the irony of that situation. I was like, what the hell am I doing? I should be solving that problem.
You are a bit of a philanthropist, what's the right word? Heart in the right place. Bleeding liberal, one of those.
you could say that.
If you're doing that as your MBA years, in your early 20s, etc., that means you're the real thing. It's not something that came with age. Don't you think?
Well, yeah.
Generally,
I think
people are at the go-getter stage of their life. They only think of me, myself. That's what I remember, and my people around me were the same.
I think I always had an interest in the tough problems. You can say that. And I think these are generally really, really hard problems.
You're too good-hearted for India. I'll drop you to the airport.
Cyrus, there are lots of good things to be here for. And there's lots of good to
like
be done.
The Volvo. You're too good. I'm getting product placement all the time.
Oh, gosh.
And when you say it, pick up Zomato. So everybody's happy.
Okay. Yeah. Importantly, so then I decided to figure out what I want to do in life. In India, this is always classic, right? You do your degrees, then you figure out what you want to do in life. So I took some time out.
Are you advising people that that's the right way to go?
No. Of course not. I'm saying it's ideal if you have this.
But let's talk about that for a second. If you have your plan in place to such a degree, I mean, it's also madness, isn't it? That you know exactly what you're doing after having your MBA.
It's not so easy. I went to the MBA without much work experience. So I think I needed that time post the MBA to figure out exactly what I wanted to do. Fortunately, I work with this NGO called Nandi Foundation, which I'm eternally grateful too, because they really exposed me to what are the ground realities of our country. So I got a chance to raise money for organic farming. I got a chance to raise money for education projects, government school education projects.
You're at the moment, you got engaged in these projects which you started doing, which are your initiatives.
Well, no, they were Nandi's initiatives, but I must tell you, one of them really took off in a big way. So I raised money for this organic coffee coffee farming project. And now there's this extremely cool coffee brand called Araku. It's organic coffee brand, which have then they started this awesome cafe in Bangalore and in Paris.
Wow,
straight. Yeah. So the farmers that grew the coffee are today, their coffee is in Paris.
Bangalore goes straight to Paris. So no other city in India.
Sorry, Cyrus, missed Bombay. Maybe when they're expanding, that's I would suggest amazing. Malabar Hill.
Yeah, well, they don't drink coffee, only whiskey. But I'm just thinking, are the tastes, the palates a little different? Up in Paris or whatever compared to the Indian coffee palate?
Hello! Bangaloreans know their coffee really well.
No, they do, but it's our thing.
What?
As in our coffee tastes a little different from the European coffee taste. The way the coffee comes out at the end of the day. So I'm thinking you just jumped into that market.
That goes to show how versatile that that coffee is, right? Anyway, so then...
If I'm asking stupid questions, press that button. You know, I have to remember where the indicator is. Please be there, you're there. Oh, there are people taking our pictures. There's a crew shooting us. Amazing. Anjali, you're looking at the wrong car.
Oh, that's sorry.
This is an Uber driver looking at you strangely.
So then what happened is then I worked at Nandi for 2.5 years. I went off and got another degree. And
where did you get the next degree?
I went to the Kennedy School.
Yes, I want to talk about this for the next half an hour.
Okay.
Because I was arguing, I didn't know Harvard Kennedy. I thought it was like some fake school. And then we Googled it as this top of the line proper Harvard thing. And then our boss, Amit Doshi's cousins have all gone there. And so now suddenly you're like a Harvard alumni, et cetera, et cetera.
So yeah, it is the school for the do-gooders, as you can imagine.
Yeah, but it's literally called that. Huh?
But I think it's a fabulous.
What was that experience like for this young girl with bright ideas? Who would just send coffee to Paris, to that third world country, France, finally getting coffee. Yeah.
So, Kennedy School is just amazing. It drew people from all walks of life and then it sent people into all walks of life. You know, we had the New York City Fire Department head at the time of 9/11 and he was a classmate.
Wow.
And then we had...
The guy who was on hand in the 9/11 tragedy was in your class.
And then, so some amazing people get to be part of that, get to be part of the Kennedy School. And it's a really famous school. It attracts people from all over the world. A lot of even IAS officers go to the Kennedy School. But importantly, what they teach you is they teach you to look at these really, really hard problems like climate change, like inequality. They teach you to look at these really hard problems analytically using data, using, understanding the politics of it.
You're looking at it and you're looking at solutions.
But the solutions are easy, right?
Fair enough, but it's always like that, right? I know the problems. Huh. I'm thinking, the problem is, what do we do about the problem?
It's a lot of, actually intergovernmental, intercorporate collaboration. Sorry, these words are really like corporate.
No.
But the point is,
our
audience
is written in saying, please use big words. They're sick of TikTok, bing bong. That's a normal conversation.
No, well, the idea is that you have to find new ways to solve these problems, right? Climate change isn't just going to, like, essentially historical emissions from one country can affect another country. You've got all of these.
Sorry, that sounded funny. Hey, but, China, take that.
But the point is, how do you solve for it? Like, even now, Delhi is under sort of,
The worst reputation.
And Delhi suffering because... farmers in other states are burning...
Is that so? The Haryana farmers killing the Delhi pollution thingy?
Well, because they're burning stubble. The stubble,
So how far does this travel?
Considerable distances, clearly. But importantly, essentially, the act of pollution might be very local, but the impact of pollution is very
I'm all about pollution myself, Anjali. Don't want to brag, but yeah. Understand.
So anyway, the point is then I did that.
So, do you master? Do you graduate in some part of that exactly?
Yeah, I did a master's in public administration.
Oh, so you can be a bureaucrat, a serving bureaucrat in India.
Not exactly.
Are you going to stand for elections?
No, I'm not. Not exactly. I can't.
Why not?
Because I've chosen this path.
Can I be your PA?
You really want to be
someone's PA? I just
want to
make money. You help people and I'll make money. Come on. Don't waste the ministership, yaar.
Cyrus.
Too many ministers will be thinking, God, how she's spoiling her name. Look, she fed a village. Look, electricity to that land. You don't do all this all the time. Also think of us.
Okay, Cyrus.
We have to send our kids to Harvard. How is that going to happen?
Cyrus, when I make this great sustainability venture and I strike it rich.
Environmental minister in the next government. You call all the shots. You have no idea.
Okay. I'm now getting career advice. Awesome.
No, I'm predicting. I'm not getting career advice. It's a prediction.
Prediction? Yeah. Wow. I'm flattered.
Well, you've got it from the corporate world. You've got a body of work which shows that your heart and your mind are in the right place. It's not like one is away from the other. And you're young. And you're a female. You know, woke is important now. Young, female, corporate, tigress, whatever the right word is. Czar of corporate India, who's also... At the same time, you know.
Who are you talking about again?
You! I'm building brand. Oh, this thanks. Is brand Anjali. Hello, I'm working. I'm spinning here. I'm spinning. So you did it. So
Cyrus, I think we've gone off in another direction.
We have to talk about your Zomato career, please.
That was my past.
Yeah. No, I was very interesting. One quick last line on that. So it's called the Howard Kennedy School. And you majored in public administration.
Yeah.
So you, I mean, it's you're an MBA. Then you got that. Then you've already got these things that you've done with that Nandi Foundation, was it?
Yeah.
And now we come to your present avatar, which is sustainability chief of Zomato. Here we are. There's the brand. And we did this liquid that you shouldn't share while you're driving. But so now let's talk about it. So what are the plans? The first big question, I'm sorry you're getting this all the time, is what about the EV delivery method? Is that a possibility?
It's not just, it's a reality. We offer EV-based deliveries in 43 cities in India. Yeah.
And the 44th is cycle. So that's good. That's good too.
Well, but actually, I think...
Can you see everyone going ahead of us? We are like so slow.
Yeah, we're really...
paralyzed.
It's okay,
fear.
It's good. Yeah. I like this speed. So, essentially, EVs are great actually for delivery partners because they're very cost effective to operationally. Of course, they're really expensive to buy initially. So we're trying to see how we can get.
Can you give us a slight idea about the cost? Like EV scooters, of course you buy it wholesale.
You know, 70 to a lakh.
It's too much, Baba. Please, as an environmental minister, I'm begging you. I wanted to buy an EV scooter for myself. This is ridiculous pricing. I can't afford that. Now, Volvo is a different matter altogether.
So importantly, I think it's really good for delivery partners to get the experience of riding EV. So what we do is
you call them delivery partners? You're talking about those boys on the cycle, the scooters.
Yeah, those are our delivery partners.
How sweet. Tumhi se baat karte hai, delivery partners. They're pretty chokras on the scooters.
What? Right?
They irritate me sometimes.
Main ja rahi hu,
I'm just kidding. Delivery partners, DP, delivery partners. Got it.
There are delivery partners, yeah. And they, so I think most of them operate using regular bikes, and a lot of them operate using secondhand bikes. So the cost difference is enormous with EVs. You know, they can't possibly just.
How do you get a secondhand EV when it's only been in the market for a year?
You can't get a secondhand EV. I'm talking about their regular bikes. A lot of them tend to be secondhand ICE vehicles,
yeah.
ICE bikes. But the important thing is that we are helping them transition by tying up with EV rental companies. So they can rent an EV bike. Yeah. And,
that makes sense.
You know, and they pay for the rent from their earnings. And yeah. Then it becomes a much more viable proposition to try EVs. And so we have about 7-8 partnerships that we're working on. A couple are already operational. Where basically we get the partner, like it could be a Zip Electric, it could be GOBP, to give our delivery partners bikes. And, we sort of negotiate the rental as well. Oh. I think what's important is that we've made a commitment that we will transition the entire fleet to 100% electric by 2030.
100% electric by 2030.
Which means all the deliveries that we make, all the orders, your order, Cyrus, from Zomato by 2030.
Oh, by the way, we are big fans of Zomato. My daughter's a card-carrying member of that special premium thing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Awesome.
And she does everything on Zomato. Her name is Maya. Tell your people.
Okay.
10% order, they don't have to come see.
Got it.
Yeah, they can. And yeah, so yeah. The other question, you sort of cleared the EV up. There's no way out of that, I guess. Everybody's going to follow you. You know that, right? So, I mean, that's the future, right? There's no way that no one else is going to...
Yeah. I mean, we do
which
believe
that... bring the pricing down a little bit, I think, also. Will it?
Well, it's going to take a while, but I think that, yes, as more models come up and more companies come into the space, there'll be a definite downward.
I have another suggestion for Zomato. Mm-hmm. In local areas, if they can keep some people who are runners. Like my wife is a runner. Mm. She runs, she's in the Chicago Marathon. Right now, they're running at this moment.
Mm.
And they're amateur runners, but they save their money and go. So why can't you get these guys to work for you? Doing deliveries on foot in small areas. Like she can run 42 kilometers. On a Sunday, they do 30 kilometers every Sunday. So, I mean, they can deliver stuff. 30 kilometers on foot. Just a suggestion. In the meantime, people are going mad. Kaun hai ye driver? Because they all try to go fast on the ceiling, except us. Yeah. Now you know what it feels like when I'm driving. Yeah.
I love the idea. I'll definitely take it back to to our logistics team.
Just give us some occupation and leave me alone. Yeah.
Well, you should know. You should know that we do have a role for runners in like malls because delivery partners can't always go up to the to the restaurant.
Right.
So we have people who work. They're walkers actually. They walk up to the restaurant and they bring the order down to the delivery partner. Would you like that job, Cyrus?
So there's a delivery partner and there's a delivery walker and they are not the same.
No, just, they're not the same.
Just remember how complicated the structure is. We're getting into the belly of the beast, you understand? Zomato's intricate details. Thank you, Anjalli, for opening my eyes. And now we come to the question which we have to ask, the parity question. Everybody talks about gender equality, gender this, this, that. And I've seen a lot of these comedians like Bill Burr and I'll go after, that females can't do this and females can't do that physically, etc., etc. There's a school of thought that says it's dangerous for women to be delivery partners, certain parts of India or the world, which, you know, you wouldn't want your mother or sister to go to or whatever. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So how do you work with that? Because I heard that there's a drive to have female.
Yeah, there is. Partners. We have more than 1,000 women delivery partners.
Oh, already?
Already.
I've never got one. I've only got these ugly men. I mean, nice men. Nice.
Well, we are increasing the numbers. And there.
Can you choose a female delivery partner instead of a male? Just because you don't want to interact with men anymore?
Not at the moment.
I mean, it's just a packet. Did you like, hello, thanks. I mean, that much.
Not right now. And I'm not sure if that's important. I think what is really important.
Oh, sweetly, you're giving me a slap. That's very nice. Idiot. I don't know. That's not so important.
What is really important is that we make sure we get as many women into what is called the mobility sector as possible. Because
it's called the mobility sector?
Yeah. Last mile deliveries are called. It's part of the larger mobility sector.
Oh.
And it's great earning opportunities. Plus, it's flexible. So the flexibility
what
is something women
are
really
flexible?
Because you can just log in for 4 hours in a day. You don't have to work the whole day.
Oh, they just do a mini shift.
Yeah, mini shift, and you don't even
can
have to
I
log in.
It?
Yeah,
I don't have work.
Abhi form bharte.
By the way, you said that your mom didn't want you to laugh, but you've laughed so much already.
Yeah, but it's not been like.
Give me the bad laugh, no.
No.
Okay, I'll tell you my favorite joke.
Okay, sure.
You know what comes? Do you know science? Are you good with science? Of course, good with science. Sorry, anything. What comes after the solar system? The Satra system.
Please, yeah, Cyrus, that's not even funny. This is like bad joke.
So forget role as a comedian. Now I don't get a role as a delivery partner, male or female. It's unbelievable. That's what my life comes to.
No. Okay, but yeah, I'll...
Okay, I'll read another one.
Yeah, okay.
A horse walks into a bar and he says, bartender, give me a drink. The bartender says, hey, why the long face?
Get it? Cyrus,
I want to end my life. Is that enough?
No, it's not. Because that joke has been funny.
Damn it.
Cyrus, you got to try harder. Sorry.
Give me one more chance.
Sorry.
But what we'll do is we'll take a break first. And then we'll come back and continue talking. We'll take the break as we hit that speed breaker. Okay, because I want to show you my ability to control this lovely Volvo XC40 Recharge. Watch this. Isn't that fantastic? You don't even feel the speed breaker. That's driving brilliance, really. Okay, so here's the break. We'll come back with Anjalli Ravi Kumar, Chief Sustainability Officer, Zomato. What's Zomato with you?
Hello, 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 everybody. It's been another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. I hope you guys are checking out Has It Aged Well on the IVM Pop feed, what used to be IVM Likes. I know it's complicated, but it's well worth your time. This week, Abbas and Urchita revisit Sanjay Bhansali's 2002 offering Devdas. Joining them for this conversation is diehard SRK fan Pulkit Kochar. On Postcards from Nowhere, Utsav discovers the connection between the iconic rock band Led Zeppelin, the children's classic Chronicles of Narnia, and Harry Potter. On This Round Is On Me, Gauri talks to chef Thomas Zacharias, founder of the Locavore. He shares his views about greenwashing, plant-based meats, and the concept of sustainability. On Think Fast, Varun and Sujita discuss Tesla's new Optimus robot, Trevor Noah quitting The Daily Show, and a whole lot more. And on Varta Lab's storytelling session, Akash and Naveen's conversation takes a political turn as they are joined by friend and fellow stand-up comic Puneet Pania. Guys, go to our website, ivmpodcast.com. You can check out the merch store, also links to all of our social media stuff, which is at IVM Podcast. Also, do check out our YouTube channels. We have a number of channels with many of your favorite shows available as full video podcasts. Finally, we'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Volvo XC40 Recharge, Bumble, Heads Up for Tails, and HDFC Mutual Fund. Thank you so much for making this possible.
Now, let's look at the sustainable plan going forward. Would you like to tell us what's in store?
Yeah.
We just discussed EVs and parity and all that, but beyond that.
So we have six themes, Cyrus, that are really, really important to our business. So the first theme is climate conscious deliveries, which essentially means that we are bringing down the emissions of our deliveries and our entire operations, actually, because we do have what is called own operation emissions, essentially emissions from our offices and our warehouses.
That's a very good point, because people always call us hypocrites. You know, it's the whole thing that it
true,
starts
true,
at home.
True, true, true. It starts at home. Absolutely. Yeah. Couldn't agree with you more. So, that is our work around climate conscious deliveries. Mainly, it's driven by this transition to EVs. I told you we're aiming for 100% electric, to go 100% electric by 2030. And it's a really big deal because we do not own our fleet. We have to persuade lakhs of delivery partners through partnerships and through behavior change programs to go electric. And it's a really big commitment that we've made. Then the second big area we're working on is waste-free world, which essentially means that we believe that as our business grows, the waste associated with the business.
That's not W-A-I-S-T, that's W-A-S-T-E. Yeah.
Good one. Good one.
Just getting worse and worse. This whole experience.
Although we're working on that too, waste. I mean, we don't want to go, okay, so I'll come to what we're doing on health separately, but to talk about waste, so the typical waste that you associate with the Zomato delivery is, it could be plastic waste, for instance, right? Mm-hmm. And while restaurants decide what kind of packaging to send the food in, we can decide how to help restaurants go greener, or how to help the business go greener. So one of the things we've done is 100% plastic neutral deliveries. What that means, before you ask me, is...
It sounded vulgar for a second.
Cyrus, only your brain can think like this, Cyrus.
Okay.
What is this? So since we're on the topic of waste, I may as well say mind in the gutter. So what it means is basically we are recycling the plastic on behalf of all the restaurants in our network. It means that we're collecting plastic waste of the same grade that goes into food containers, and we're collecting it back from municipal waste streams, and we're making sure it gets recycled. So that's, again, a really huge commitment we've made to make sure all deliveries are plastic neutral.
Wow. Yeah, I don't even feel like opening the plastic bag and, I just leave it there. I'm changing now, but listening to you,
Do you segregate your waste, Cyrus?
I do. I've kept my aunts and uncles separately. that's the laugh. You got it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Serious ho jao, yeah. And then we have this, we have a pillar on health, safety and well-being for all. Mm-hmm. And you'll see that, we've now started offering healthy eating options through a feature on an app called Healthy. So you can filter for healthy restaurants, or restaurants that use like better oils.
Okay, so healthy to do with the waste and healthy to do with the environment, not necessarily the same thing.
No, this is human health.
Okay. I have a friend, Neeraj, who uses the same oil on his hair and in his cooking. I think that's one way to save, because you're using the same product and you're sort of recycling it. If this is not a fair point, I'll just complain to your mom.
So actually, coconut oil, for instance, has multiple uses. So tell your friend, go ahead. It's perfectly fine. And by the way, certain things in coconut oil taste good. You know,
Neeraj smells of coconut oil. Yeah.
I used to work in Kerala where they even fried eggs in coconut oil. Mm. It was interesting.
Well, he's never been able to have a relationship for long because of his coconut oil fetish. Here's a cop breaking the law and opening the thing and going himself through the middle gate, which is not allowed. That's a policeman breaking the law. Once again, brought to you by Cyrus Drives. I won't take the sponsor's name because I want them to get worried that I'm taking on powerful forces like the police. We have only come to three.
Mm. Let me get quickly to the fourth. The fourth is actually, have you heard of Feeding India? Which is this initiative that we run in collaboration with an NGO called Hunger Heroes. Right. So Zomato allows all its users to contribute towards meals for underserved populations. So, you know, unfortunately, we're in a world where there's plenty of food, but people are still hungry, right? Hunger and malnutrition exist despite lots of food being available. And basically, we're giving all users of the app a way to contribute to ending hunger and malnutrition through a contribution to Feeding India. You'll see it at the checkout page. And what the Feeding India campaign does is...
So am I paying for something or am I actually physically doing something?
No, you're actually just making a contribution. It can be as little as 3 rupees to 5 rupees.
Whatever the lowest amount is, count me in.
Woohoo! We've got a donor. Yeah. All right. So it's like easy squeezy kind of.
No, but these things I don't mind because I think at the end of the day you're doing something which benefits somebody else literally in an organized process. I'm okay with that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So
And it doesn't hurt your wallet because at the end of the day charity has a limit. Yeah.
Fair point.
No, other people won't do it, right? You have to find there's a line. Yeah.
You have to make it really easy as well as impactful. Yeah. So the good part is because we are collecting donations from millions of customers of Zomato, we managed to make it a sizable enough amount to then give to NGOs. We don't give it to the NGOs. We give it to kitchens that prepare food, at which NGOs pick up for their students. Typically, it's NGOs teaching students in slums. NGOs working with the elderly, NGOs working with women. We're really focused right now on NGOs and government bodies working with pregnant women and children because those are the segments of the population for whom hunger and malnutrition is a severe risk to their health, and it's also a major problem in India. So Feeding India donations are really, really impactful. And,
they have broken the light.
Did you?
I don't know. I'm not sure. Sorry, don't stop talking.
Okay, all right.
I'm scared now.
Yeah,
I have to act sincere.
I'm like wondering if the cops are going to come chase
no,
us.
No.
Do you have a plan? Do you have a script?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Okay, all right.
Did you send a challan to the owner of the car, who is not me? Ting, 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 ting.
Cyrus, okay. As long as it doesn't come on my side.
Of course not. Here you're trying to save the world. Huh. Feed India. Yeah. Look at what all the noble things you're doing. Why should you pay a red light fee of somebody else's? That's not charity. That's stupidity. I won't allow it.
So Feeding India is one of Zomato's biggest social sustainability initiatives. And it contributes to one of the UN Sustainable Development Goals, which is zero hunger. So I think one of the...
I'll tell you another thing which you may or may not have thought of. It's quite a psychological ploy also that when you're eating, you feel guilty. And then I think if you give $3, it's not going to kill you.
Yeah, exactly.
On a 2,700 rupee order, $3 is really not going to kill you. But let's keep it at $3. Let's get excited.
Okay, Cyrus. Yeah. As long as you promise to order 3 times a day.
I know. Listen, hello. We are big Zomato and Volvo supporters. These two sponsors should be very happy with me. And by the way, thanks to you guys, we survived the pandemic.
That is very true. Very true.
How many people are emotionally attached to you guys? You have no idea. Because it's like, my God, without them, what would I have done? I mean, mom, we like your food, but hey, you know what I mean? Like, really? Come on.
I think mom was also very happy that you were ordering.
Come on, really? It was ridiculous. Can't be stuck at home like that.
Yeah.
Never again. I'm just going to declare war next time it happens.
And?
Anything's better than the pandemic. Let's just go to war.
With the virus?
Let's just say
against the virus. How good is that? How
Where's
good
the
is
laugh?
That?
Where's the laugh now? Anjali's mom, help!
Cyrus versus the virus.
Now we'll drive.
You should have did shows like that,
no? Always. Every 8 millionth person has told me that. And they all think they're the first person to come up with this joke. And I have to act like, wow, how creative. Harvard Kennedy School, is it? Yeah.
Cyrus, now you know.
Yeah.
Okay. So, okay, that was the fourth thing.
One more. Yeah, one more.
There is actually two now, more. Okay, very quickly.
Take your time. We'll do one more round. Also, I can now drive fast because I know that I'm bored of these guys following us. So it's an audio show.
Okay, cool. So the fifth and the sixth things are sustainable livelihoods, which, you know, we help restaurants expand thanks to deliveries. We also help, you know, create these earning opportunities for delivery partners. And then we're really focused on diversity, equity, and inclusion. I told you, right? There's a way to find LGBTQ friendly.
No, that will be offline. Tell me that again.
There's a way that you can find LGBTQ friendly restaurants on your Zomato app, especially if you're a dining in customer. So if you want to go and
where they are welcome, you welcome all.
Well, they're a lot more friendly to LGBTQI.
So there's
community.
No his or her bathrooms. It's them.
No, that's not the case. No, that's not the case. You know, at least they're,
LGBT?
You walk in with your partner.
So the person feels, everybody feels respected is what you're saying?
Exactly.
Or is there special things done?
Exactly.
No, it's not.
There are no special physical provisions in restaurants, but they are very open and friendly and comfortable with you walking in with your partner or if you're gathering with
a Are you doing anything for dogs?
Pet friendly, of course.
Oh, thank you. I mean, not that I'm against LGBT, that's good too. But I'm more dog person.
Kid friendly.
Kids, too many of them. Really, come on.
Cyrus?
You had a nice thing going with dogs. I'm okay with the LGBTQ. No, I can't
You
kids.
Have dogs?
I have dogs, I have kids, and I have only LGBTQ friends.
So, I think, I have dogs myself. So
What dog do you have?
I have two Shih Tzus. I got them in
now. Oh, so sweet.
Yeah,
they are. The government, they're anti-China. So, we haven't finished. We've got 1.5 more points.
Is it?
No, you haven't told me in the diversity, LGBTQ, then what else?
Oh, and then we're doing this really cool thing. We're really focused on hiring women into technology. So, we're running a hackathon exclusively for women and trans members of the trans community. A hackathon exclusively for
How
women.
How do I become a member of the trans community? How do you apply?
Cyrus, this is not for you.
But can I apply if I don't get into the male or female quota? I'm just thinking of what Jugaad can happen. Jugaad will happen.
You need a reference to get into Zomato. You can't just get in like
Baba,
so easily.
I'm telling you,
and all
guys are joking about this. This is India. People find ways into anything. You know, you just have to
You have
that.
To be really nice to me.
Oh, that's it. God, easy peasy.
You can't laugh at my laugh. Or you can't.
Your mom is saying that. You have to blame your mom, not me. How dare you talk badly about your mom? Where were we? Right, so we still have one.
So yeah, we're through with the six. Climate conscious deliveries, waste-free world, health, safety, well-being for all.
If you hold, we'll play music. Blink.
Sustainable livelihoods.
Nice.
Diversity, equity and inclusion.
Nice. And?
Zero hunger.
And zero hunger.
Yeah.
End hunger.
Yeah. So this is my job as well. I get to work on all of these issues. It's a really...
I've been pulling your leg, Anjali, but a lot of respect because obviously, you know, you've not changed from that teenager, early adult, young MBA who wanted to...
Only
you know,
the waistline, yeah.
Who cares about all that crap anyway? The world is not defined by how big or small the waist is. It's defined by the size of the heart. Words of the famous writer Iqbal, dil bhi ek cheez hai. He never said that. But I know a guy called Iqbal, I used to play cricket with. He might have said that. Okay, quickly, we have about 5 minutes left. Now, let's talk about your other life, which is, what else do you do outside the corporate world? How does Anjali relax?
Oh, I'm taking these really cool breathing classes.
You mean you haven't done it before?
No, I have, but I've just discovered that it's wonderful to do like these focused breathing lessons. I can't tell you.
Kriya?
It's changing my life. No, not Kriya. Although that is another sort of kind of breathing class one can do. But I'm doing this with this amazing teacher, Gayatri, thank you.
Gayatri, thank you.
Yeah, and it's awesome because you suddenly realize that you can create a lot of clarity for yourself if you breathe right. And if you just focus on your
own. I heard a lot about this. The oxygen content going in and all is very important.
And my teacher says really cool things like the breath will protect you.
Well,
it's pretty cool, right?
If your breath is terrible like mine, it will protect you. You should be safe from a lot of people. I get what Gayatri ma'am, Gayatri Swami ji is saying. Yeah.
So
when you say breathing classes, it's an actual physical class or you're online?
No, I'm online. Minutes? I'm online.
For a few minutes or it's like a full hour or something?
It's a full hour.
Of just breathing? Why, talk about great comedy. I mean, it's really.
No, but it's awesome.
I mean, there are two things. Breathe in, breathe out.
No.
Teach out for 1 hour.
No, it's much more than that. It's mind opening.
Excellent.
So that
tells us about you. So you're one of those people who likes to keep reinventing yourself, finding different things. You're not one of those rigid, I'm stuck in one zone kind of person.
Yeah, I am. I do like to experiment. Yeah.
And a little flexible and accepting in that sense.
Yeah.
So what else do you do to relax? What are your fun things you do other than breathing?
I love hanging out with my dogs. They're really cute.
This is Bangalore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're really cute. And of course, I have a 9-year-old daughter who keeps me in check and puts me in my place.
Yeah. Does she also do the eyebrow? I found with the daughters.
I try telling her all of these things like, sport is the best form of exercise. And she'll say, come on, mom, you're so old-fashioned. So I get to hear all of these dialogues from her.
But Demi, does she do the eyebrows thing? I found with my daughter, as against my son, the eyebrow thing happened a lot. As in the lack of respect for whatever you said or done. The eyebrows. It is, right? It's a female thing. It's just such an expression.
Did you learn from YouTube?
I don't know. But
we should not let them watch YouTube.
It's too late. Like, if I just say good morning, I get eyebrows. You know, the eyebrows, it's a contempt. It's not mean contempt. It's passive contempt, but it's still contempt.
Yeah, it's so true.
Yeah.
And you feel like, my God, what have I just
I'm
said?
I'm scared.
Right?
I've lost confidence with my daughter. I'm like, I'm going to stumble.
I totally agree with you. So, I always feel like I'm getting jacked. Every time I have any conversation with her, have your breakfast,
thing.
Raised eyebrows.
Raised eyebrows.
It's dosa for breakfast, raised eyebrows.
Yeah,
I'm like...
Good or bad is immaterial. You still get that contempt feeling.
Yeah, absolutely. Cyrus.
You're never going to be good enough for your daughter. Remember that. That's the law.
I swear. Kids these days.
Kids. Mm. Enough of this recycling.
I know, it's easier to be with the dogs, no?
Oh, you're judging how can so you much. Compare? They won't watch this, no? Or your mom will not be laughing anymore.
They don't judge you, yeah. But it's awesome that your wife is running a marathon.
At the moment, at this exact price, 9.5 hours ahead.
So that's incredibly inspiring. You should tell her.
I will.
You should tell her that she's an inspiration.
It.
Okay.
Yeah. No, she's one of those people. Have you noticed this trend? As we're about to end, I'll just finish this.
Huh.
A lot of people in urban India, people like ourselves, they land up turning to sports, you know, in their 40s. Have you noticed that? Men go to golf, men and women running, yoga, all these things, but they've not done it till 35. And then suddenly they start doing it with great zeal. It's like they wasted that enthusiasm in youth. I'm telling you.
So sad. I don't know if they wasted it, but they do. They have this, they just changed their lives. Yeah.
Anjalli Ravi Kumar, Chief Sustainability Officer, Zomato. Thank you for your present. It's really nice of you to give me this. It's only water, right?
You can have it, Cyrus.
No, don't be silly. But like I said...
You are so good. And plus, you order from Zomato all the time.
I'm not lying. I'm not going to be a chela. We are complete fans of Zomato, my entire family. And of course, you know that...
And you contribute to Feeding India by your own admission.
Yeah, we do. Because she always tells me you have an option of giving money to something. Because she uses my phone to do it. And I don't have my glasses, so I just have to listen. And then the eyebrows. So I never argue with my daughter because I want to avoid the eyebrows. So whatever she
please
says...
Please thank your daughter.
Yeah. Well,
Maya, no?
Maya.
Thank you,
Maya. That's it. Maya, if you're watching, it's from a very important person. Get your job as a delivery agent person.
Yes, she can be our female delivery partner, ambassador.
Hey, check it out, the wipers. As we say bye. Okay, Anjalli, it's time for us to say bye.
Maybe they have a brain of their own.
Oh, I think they just Volvo is just playing with me. Hey, idiot, check this out.
But it's very comfy.
A supercar. It's a great car, really, honestly. I'm going to give it to you.
And it really has Harman's speakers.
It does. Of course it does. I just don't know how to play anything yet. I'm learning slowly.
Except the sound of your own voice.
Yeah. The show. I've stopped the show as well as the Vipers. Chavi.